about individual sectors, and it's been a very prolonged phase of slowdown that one has seen for capital goods all of 2018. But now with improved sentiment, a pickup in the short cycle, large orders are still very few and concentrated. What then is the sector outlook for 2019? Avan joins in with a quick synopsis on how 2018 has been and how are we really gearing up in 2019.
Well, the capital goods sector, remember, has been at the receiving end of a prolonged phase of a slowdown. But the year 2018 did see an improvement in the investment sentiment, a pickup in the short cycle orders, an overall pickup in construction activities, as well as demand for power equipment. All of that really seems to have helped. We've seen large orders, though, that have been few and far between. L&T, Siemens, ABB, Voltas have bagged robust orders. They've seen strong growth as well in order intake. The new project announcements as well have increased. So what's on the anvil for 2019 for the sector? Well, they are showing early signs of recovery. The government spending on roads, railways and smart cities is going to help. The overall capacity expenditure as well is resuming in consumer-oriented industries. And while smaller capex has come on stream, the large ticket investments are not still happening. IBC, recapitalization of PSU banks, all of that is going to help to lower the risk averseness. You also have the smart cities, the smart infrastructure, all of that will help through the adoption of urbanization. A stable government and general elections as well in the long term can help the overall cycle gain momentum. You might just see, though, a lull in the awarding contracts as the government comes under election. Some of the concerns, though, are still going to remain, the likes of the direction of crude oil prices, which remain utterly volatile. That's going to be a major risk. The shrinkage in liquidity as well can pose a risk for the sector. The global protectionist policies as well as trade war can impact the export-oriented businesses. And the outlook for West Asian markets, that continues to remain gloomy due to the political instability. But by and large, we are seeing an improvement overall. Let's hear it from the management of Thermax and BHEL on the road ahead.
Oh yes, Aman. In fact, we have with us K. Ravi Kumar, the former CMD at BHEL, and Mr. M. S. Unnikrishnan, MD and CEO at Thermax, currently joining in on the show. Gentlemen, morning. I just want to quickly bring Mr. Unnikrishnan as well in on the discussion. And Mr. Unnikrishnan, you know, we have seen some improvement in investment sentiment. There has been a pickup in short cycle orders from the public. How has this helped the growth in the sector so far, you think?
Those who are into equipment manufacturing and sales in the capital goods and engineering sector are reporting very good results. However, those who are dependent upon the larger projects, infra projects and government funded projects are not seeing the uptick happening beyond the level. So the private capex, which is of the limited nature and mid-sized kind of projects in maybe 20 and odd different sectors like textiles, food processing, alcohol, beverages, light engineering, pharma, auto ancillaries, tire cord manufacturing, carbon black, all the sectors are investing, and those who are dependent upon these sectors are doing quite well at this type of paradigm in terms of growth as well as order intake. However, those who are dependent upon the road projects, those who are dependent upon the very large oil and gas refinery, plastic industry, heavy chemicals, steel and cement are yet to be seeing light of the day in terms of the growth story happening for
them. Right. But Mr. Unnikrishnan, you know, large orders have been concentrated in only select sectors. What is the sense that you are getting about the outlook for order inflows for your company as well as the overall sector too?
See, the larger sectors that do contribute to the project orders for companies like Thermax, starting with power, I need to say it's a wash off and there is nothing is going to be happening for some more time to happen. However, there had been selective ordering which had happened in the last 1 year period of time in the steel industry by two large companies. One order came to our organization, another one went to another larger company in the country. We've seen fertilizer industry going ahead with captive power ordering and also expansion for two specific locations. And I think it is going to be continuing in that sector of the sector. Oil and gas had been a real disappointment in the last year. Though they have gone ahead with the ordering for the Bharat 6 related refinery upgradation, we have not seen as many orders happening for the fresh capacity expansion for the refinery, which is anticipated to happen in the last year. With an election year ahead, I don't think any ordering is going to happen for one more year in the oil and gas sector. Then coming to cement sector, there had been fairly good traction happening for the green energy, which is a waste heat being converted into self-generation of power. That had been going at a very fast pace last year, and I'm expecting it to be continuing for the next 1 year. Brownfield expansion had been limited to only one or two, so I'm expecting a lot more of greenfield and brownfield capacity expansion program in cement industry in the next 18-month period of time. So these are the major industries which you can talk about in terms of forward ordering for larger projects.
Right. Mr. Unnikrishnan, you know, the direction of crude oil prices, I guess, would also be a major risk for your sector. With the acute volatility, how is it that you see the sector dealing with this issue?
In fact, I would say that even $50-$55 for a barrel is an investment grade in terms of oil and gas sector and plastic sector. India, in any case, do not have to look at what are the crude oil price, because it's an imported item for India. We need to look at the automobile production, which is rising up, though people may be complaining that in the last 1 or 2 months there had been a reduction in auto sales, but per se the quantum of new automobiles coming on the road being so high, we need to increase our refining capacity. And I am hopeful that even at $50, $55, even $40 and above, oil and gas makes hell of a lot of sense in terms of capacity expansion for a capacity constrained country like India. And the global market also, despite the prices having come down by 70% in the last maybe 6 to 7 month period, we still see inquiries prevailing for capacity expansion.
Kumar, you know, as we, Mr. Ravi Kumar, Mr. Unnikrishnan, thank you both of you for taking the time out and joining in, and hopefully it's a happy 2019, not just for the capital goods sector, but for all of us as well. Here's wishing you from all of us here at DT Now.
Thank you.
Okay, let's take a very quick break on that note with news that we're pretty much status quo actually from where we started off, haven't moved much. In fact, if nothing, we're scaling at the highest point in the day. It's a good 1% move that you're seeing. So 10,900 is where the index is right now. Let's see whether we manage to sustain these levels as we wind down 2019. Still